Hey everyone, Shannon here. This may cause some debate, and before you go banging on your keyboards, commenting, telling me why I need to switch to this tool or that tool, this is why I continue to use the Adobe Creative Suite. Hear me out and why I see value in their tools and in their brand. Many users became upset when Adobe moved to a subscription-based service. I remember that I was at first. I understand that a one-time payment for software like Photoshop or Adobe Premiere Elements may have been better for some people. Some creatives may still be using older versions of the software, and that's okay, as long as it does what you need it to do. However, here are three reasons why I still use Adobe products and why I will continue to use the Adobe Creative Suite. And no, this video is not sponsored by Adobe. I've been a loyal user for a long time. I enjoy all of Adobe's products, developments, tools, their conferences, and all that good stuff. So number one is Adobe Dynamics Link. If you don't know what Adobe Dynamic Link is, it's essentially a workflow tool that allows you to take parts of a project or a whole project from one Adobe app into another Adobe app. You can import it, integrate it, and work on it in real time. For example, I do a lot of work in Adobe After Effects and Adobe Premiere for my client videos. I'll have a big motion graphics project in Adobe After Effects, and I want to use that motion graphic in my Adobe Premiere sequence for my finished video. So instead of wasting time constantly rendering in Adobe After Effects, we all know, you know, if you don't have enough RAM, how painstakingly slow the render process is in Adobe After Effects on big projects. I do also have a video on how to speed up that process for your machine. Check that out too. But let's just say I rendered an entire composition and I import it into Premiere and I find out, oh my gosh, I have a misspelled word, or it's not, you know, behaving the way that I want it to. I made a mistake somewhere. Instead of going back into After Effects, re-rendering, fixing again, re-rendering, importing it back in Premiere as a MOV or an AVI or something like that, the best and truest form is using Adobe Dynamic Link, because what it does is it imports the After Effects composition. You can see it. And if you make a mistake, you can go back to After Effects, make your changes, and Adobe Premiere updates it in real time once it's saved. So to do that, you just go to File in Adobe Premiere and you select Adobe Dynamic Link and import the After Effects composition. And you can select the comp that you made in After Effects and it imports as a piece of content in Premiere. So again, the cool thing is once I make changes to my After Effects composition, it reflects in Adobe Premiere. I don't have to render anything. So this is a huge, huge time saver, and it's very efficient for your workflow. You can also import Adobe Audition projects, Photoshop files, Illustrator files, work right from a vector file, right from the raw format. You don't need to render anything and import it and export it and import and export it. You don't need to do any of that stuff. Basically, the entire Adobe suite works kind of like a big master project between all of these apps. Number two is ultimate collaboration. Adobe acquired Frame.io, which was a platform that I found super helpful for collaborating remotely and accepting client revisions. Because Adobe is cloud-based, in Premiere, it allows for remote collaboration on video projects by selecting File, New, Team Project, and you can add collaborators from anywhere in the world. And you can also convert previous projects to team projects. And you could check out the version history when multiple people are editing a project. So this is a total game changer for remote work and being able to collaborate with anyone no matter where they are. Number three is updates. If you find what seems to be like constant updates from the Adobe apps really annoying, then this reason might not be for you, but I absolutely love the updates. I appreciate the updates and the new features to the software. This is especially helpful as a creator if you want to try out new tools that are in beta versions, provide feedback on them to Adobe. Adobe's AI tools and technology are always available and updated, which helps me as a creator always stay on top of the digital trends and new technologies that my clients may ask for. Generative AI, automatic keyframing, and Lightroom's AI tools are some of my favorites and the ones I use most in my projects. Now, there are pros and cons to every software, hell, any topic in the world. So I wanted to give you reasons why I still use Adobe because it works for me. And it's important to choose wisely. I wanted to give you that information so you can make the best choice of what works for you and your creative process. I'm also a fan of DaVinci Resolve. It's super hot right now. It's free. It's chock full of all these tools. That's awesome. I think that's great. I love Blackmagic design. I use the Blackmagic Pocket Cinema cameras. Absolutely love the updates that they come out with. So I'm not against, you know, trying out new tools or software. I'm open to it. I think that the world of digital content is changing more rapidly than ever. So that's why it's so important to stay updated and stay relevant, not so much what's trendy. And I understand the budget constraints. So find what works best for you. All right, if you like this video, hit the like button, comment on what software and digital creation tools that you use for your process that help you. And as always, thanks for watching and keep creating.